our first video on lines and linear equations in business, we ended here with figure 11, which shows the graph of the line y equals 2x minus 1 in Excel. I did not mark the axes in Excel, but the vertical axis is here where the numbers are located. That is the y-axis, and the horizontal axis is the x-axis. The points marked with dots on this graph are at the xy coordinates that we calculated out in example 7.1, including the three points that we used on our earlier graph in example 8.1. So in 8.1, we graphed the point negative 1, negative 3, negative 1, comma, negative 3. We graphed the points 0, comma, negative 1, the y-intercept. And we graphed the point 0.5, comma, 0, which is the x-intercept. The graph in figure 11 doesn't look as steep as it did in example 8.1, simply because the x-axis scale is stretched relative to the y-axis. So that doesn't substantively change the graph. The slope is 2, which is a positive number. And the significance of that is shown on this graph because this line climbs from lower left to upper right. So it slopes upward from left to right. That's what a positive slope does to a line. In terms of the variables, what that means is that when the slope of a line is positive, as x increases, y increases. So as x goes from negative 1 to 0, y goes from negative 3 to negative 1, which is an increase. As x goes from 0 to 1, y goes from negative 1 to 1, which is an increase. So mathematically, that's what a positive slope does. You have likely heard that the slope is the rise over the run. The run has a specific meaning in that saying. The run is a step of 1 to the right on the x-axis. So it's an increase of 1 in x. Given that definition of run, what a slope of positive 2 means is that this line rises 2 steps up the y-axis for every step in a positive direction along the x-axis. So it rises up 2 steps for a run of 1 step. Rises 2 steps up y for a run of 1 step in x. How do we see that on this graph? Well, for example, let's take the step in x from 1 to 2, which is 1 step long, right? We add 1 to 1 and we get 2. So what we did in the x direction, or the x dimension, is step from 1 to 2 in x, so that's 1 step. We start here at the beginning of that step. We end here at the end of that step. So we moved 1 step in x. What happened to y? Well, y went from 1, which is the y-coordinate of the first point, to 3, which is the y-coordinate of the second point. So y went up 2 steps. Now you can see that that is replicated for any step of 1. So if we took the step from negative 1 to 0 on the x-axis, again, we're getting 1 step here. And to get from the first point to the second, we go from negative 3 on the y-axis to negative 1 on the y-axis, so that is a step up the y-axis of 2. So 1 step over means 2 steps up. Now a negative slope imparts a different and distinctive shape to the line. So let's consider the line y equals negative 3x plus 6. Because b equals 6 in this expression, the y-intercept is 0, comma 6, because b is what y equals when x equals 0. To calculate another point, let's plug in x equals 2. We get y equals negative 3 times 2 plus 6, which equals 0. So the point 2, comma 0 is on this line. And that actually happens to be the x-intercept, because that's going to be where the graph is going to cross the x-axis. Starting with those two points, let's use Excel to graph this line. And we're going to end up replicating figure 12. Here we are in Excel. Now, Excel can graph a line given only two points. But doing a scatter plot with only two creates a situation in which Excel is not sure what you want to graph. And addressing that is more advanced in Excel than I want to get. So we are going to get around that by calculating a third point on this line. Given that third point, Excel will not get confused, plus you will get more practice with Excel. So it's a win-win. So what I have here is the two points that we have already calculated, 0, 6 and 2, 0. And I want to calculate a third point. We can certainly do this by hand. We've done that a number of times. But we're using an equation, and we can use Excel to calculate a value for us. So the equation we're graphing is y equals negative 3x plus 6. I'm just typing that in there so we can look at it. How can we use Excel to calculate a point for us? Well, we can plug in a value of x. What I'm going to type into cell A4 is 3.5. Just choosing 3.5 because I want to. I could choose 4 or 10 or something else. It would change what Excel shows because it's going to show the points that you calculate, but they would still be on the same line. Now to calculate y is dependent on x in this case. We have a value of x, so we can calculate y given our equation. To do that, what I'm going to do is invoke calculation in Excel by hitting the equal sign. The slope is negative 3, so I type negative 3. It is multiplied by the value of x. The asterisk is the multiplication operator in Excel. In order to multiply negative 3 by my value of x, I could certainly type in 3.5. I could certainly do that, but that's called hard coding. And there's no reason to do that if you have the value in a different cell in Excel. So instead of typing 3.5, I'm going to click on the cell A4 where 3.5 is located, the value that I've typed before. And then I'm going to add the 6. I did not have to place parentheses around any of this because the multiplication is a higher order of operations than the addition. So the multiplication is going to take place first. I'm going to hit enter and I get the value negative 4.5. Now that we have the three points we're going to graph, start making the graph by clicking the insert tab. Highlight the data that you want to graph. You see I'm including these headings x and y into this. Even though they're not data, Excel handles that naturally and even occasionally in a helpful way when it comes to graphs. Because the x variable is on the left-hand side in these two columns, the x variable is going to be graphed on the horizontal axis. On the Insert tab, once I've highlighted my data, go to the Charts group and the Insert Scatter XY or Bubble Chart button. Click the down arrow, and you can choose different things here. If you choose a simple scatter, you see that the points are graphed, but not the line. So when you graph data that is XY type data points, you can use a scatter plot without them being on the same line. But in this case, we're going to go to scatter with straight lines and markers, and Excel makes our graph. You see the x-axis is here, the numbers are along it, the y-axis is the vertical axis and the numbers are along that. It's added a chart title that's not very helpful, so I'm going to click on it and type graph of y equals negative 3x plus 6. The negative slope here shows up in the downwardly sloping line from left to right. So that's the distinctive shape of a negative slope on a line. The slope, which just as a reminder is the coefficient on the x variable, the constant multiplied by the x variable, is negative 3. This means that for every run of one step on the x-axis, the y value falls by 3 steps. So the negative tells you that the y falls. So in the case of a negative slope, the slope characterizes how much the y value drops for each step of plus 1 in x. So it's not exactly rise over run, right? It's drop over run or fall over run. So on this graph, let's look at a step of 1 in x from 0 to 1. So that would be this. That would be one step in x. So for this line, when you are at x equals 0, you're here at 6 on the y-axis. By the time you get to 1, you're here at 3 on the y-axis. So you see you go down from 6 to 3, 3 steps down. Looking at this step from 2 to 3, which is another step of 1, you could go 2.5 to 3.5. You could do whatever step of 1, but you have one step up the x-axis in this direction, going from your x-intercepts to this point here. So how far down in y have we gone? Over that step in x, we've gone down to negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, right? So that's 3 steps down. That's what the slope of negative 3 means.